your number one news team covering the North. The Bahamas Tonight, Northern Edition.
Welcome back. This is an election year for the Grand Bahama Christian Council. Tonight, the president of the Grand Bahama Christian Council sits down with Jamil Mizik to give an overview of his tenure and what he would like to see accomplished as election looms.
Grand Bahama Christian Council President Reverend Robert Lockhart says the past 2 years serving as the council's president has been an exciting journey, noting that unfortunately they were unable to achieve all of their objectives, but he's thankful to his team for the work they've done during their tenure, and he remains hopeful that moving forward more goals will be met.
But we're satisfied with the level of cooperation that we've gotten from our pastors and churches on the island of Grand Bahama. We've had great synergy in working together. We've not had a great challenge in that area. So even though we still have pastors and churches that are not involved to the level that we'd like them to be, but we've had great cooperation whenever we needed it from all of our churches and pastors once we've reached out to them. And so that's one thing that we've achieved. Also, Always keeping a listening ear to what the community is saying, what the needs of the people are, what some of their concerns are, and speaking to them. We've tried our best to do that. I don't think we've always done it successfully or spoken to everything that we probably should have, and that's something we will continue to work at.
Now, Reverend Lockhart says he intends on offering himself again for a second term. However, he notes that the council has missed their constitutional deadline for elections, which should be held every 2 years on the third Tuesday in January. He says they will have a general meeting before the end of the month to finalize a date for elections.
Of course, but what we've been through with the hurricane and all of the challenges that we've had, of course, has affected some of our plans, somewhat changed a lot of plans that we would have had. But I think the Christian Council have done a tremendous job working and helping to navigate the community and being of much help as we can, helping the community recover from the aftermath of Hurricane Dorian, and working very closely with some of our NGOs that are especially faith-based, and working with them. And so it's been a tremendous exercise.
Lockhart says he has seen an increase in participation in the Grand Bahama Christian Council, especially after Hurricane Dorian, as they have been working consistently with over 107 churches to help the community, adding that he hopes that level of participation will continue. He says, now more than ever, the role of the church and its mandate should be displayed.
People are in greater need, and some people who weren't in need are now in need. And many of those people are people that are connected to our churches and in our communities, and so the church even has to step it up even more. And as we do that, we continue to provide hope to let people know that God has not abandoned you, and he will not abandon you, and he will use his church and people in the church and leaders in the church to continue to be a channel of God's provision, of God's assistance, and God's help, because God is a present help in time of trouble.
Jamila Mizik, ZNS Network News.
And finally, in news this evening, the Falcons Boys Club reaching yet another milestone. The program is celebrating 23 years as an organization mentoring young men in the community. Youth leader and mentor Dan Roll says the club believes in building youth rather than mending men. In celebrating their anniversary, a fun day and celebration is planned for Saturday, January 25th at the Champs Community Center near the Hawksville gas station, and he's inviting all young men to attend.
The Falcons Boys Club is a program that is geared towards one thing, and that one thing only is to use the opportunity to be able to help to build the young men in our community. On Saturday, January 25th, we're going to have all the gifts that you could think of, all the giveaways that you could think of, exclusively for young men and young men who attend this anniversary celebration.
And RJ Philippe is live in studio, and I heard that you had the best night ever.
Well, it was certainly an exciting night at the St. George's Gymnasium in the annual Pizza Hut Basketball Classic, something you don't want to miss.
Stingers all the way. Stay with us, Jay Philippe has the details.